You're watching ZTV.
You're watching ZTV.
I hope you're having a wonderful Tuesday, February 19th, 2019. It is turning out to be a really awesome year, which the Lord said it would be, being that it's the year of abundant harvest. So I hope you are experiencing great abundance in whatever area of your life that you really need it in, but also in those areas that you've had it in the past. I want to share a few different things with you today. I have some testimonies, of course, because God's always doing stuff and always answering prayer. And then I have a couple things about affirmations versus prophetic decrees, and also about some prayer strategies. So let's go ahead and give thanks. Lord, we just thank you for who you are, for all that you do for us, for all that you're going to do for us, for everything that's in the works. We thank you for giving us glimpses into the spiritual realm and helping us to pull those things that you've already ordained for us as blessings and provision and just regular plans for our lives into this natural realm for manifestation. We thank you that we are continually moving from glory to glory and faith to faith. I pray that everybody who watches this is blessed exceedingly and moves up to a new level from where they are before they watch it. I declare this all by faith and seal it with Holy Spirit. In Jesus' name, amen. All right, so real quickly, this doesn't have anything to do with what I plan to say, but I wanted to tell you anyway. If you need to increase your faith, which I'd probably say 95% of believers do, then you need to be watching the Kenneth Hagin Legacy people. So Kenneth Hagin is fantastic at building your faith. And then some of his legacy students like Kenneth Copeland and Bill Winston and Jesse Duplantis and Jerry Savelle and Oral Roberts' teachings, of course, and then also Norvell Hayes. Like, if you need some serious faith infusion in your life so that you can begin living in faith and operating in faith, then get those legacy teachers put on replay constantly. I've been listening to them all nonstop since October. It was when the Lord flipped me to faith in 2016. I got a little bit of it. And then he flipped me again last year, like big time. And then I was like, no. It's not working, which of course you never want to say when you're trying to move forward in faith. And then in October, he like totally flipped me again in faith. And I've been moving full steam ahead ever since then. And let me tell you something, when you get flipped to faith, you realize how negative everybody else around you is. They're always like, oh my gosh, I'm getting sick. Well, why would you say that? You know, if that's where you're putting your faith, yes, that's going to come to pass for you. And even believers, you're like, they're always like, oh, could you pray for me? This hurts. And I'm like, well, tell it to stop hurting. You know, where's your faith? You use your faith for the things that God said we can use it for. I've also been reading through the Gospels and listening to the Gospels on audio as I go to sleep and stuff, just keeping my faith where I need it to be. And I have really cut off a lot of communication and a lot of all kind of stuff because so many people speak so negatively. When you get flipped to faith, you'll notice how negative everybody is. You're not going to want to be on social media most of the time because they're always complaining. Even believers, they're like, they post all this stuff telling you what's going wrong in the world and what all these politicians are doing wrong and this, you know, what the Church of Satan is doing in the United States right now, what Muslims are doing, all that stuff, instead of posting the directives of the Lord. You know, God is more powerful than all of that stuff that's going on. And we need to switch from, we're just praying, Lord, help, Lord, move in this area, to saying by prophetic decree, I declare that this is what's happening, and then believing and expecting that to follow up. So if, you know, a believer with influence can start saying that stuff and speaking what they want into, you know, the government and all that stuff in the United States, then other people get on board and things will begin to change. But you're listening to me right here say that, so you can be that person that starts the change. It may just be for your, you know, you just may have a small group of influence like I do, but you could be changing those people's speech and faith and mindset so that they become more kingdom ambassador oriented as opposed to being victims because of what everything else is going on. Then, you know, then things will begin to change. And that's what God is expecting. That's what the ecclesia is for. It's for a government. Remember, Jesus said that Isaiah says that his kingdom is coming to order and establish. You know, we're here to take dominion. And it also says that his rule is ever increasing. We are the ones who are supposed to be demonstrating that stuff on the earth. You know, that's another thing that I kind of want to testify about. The Lord has been completely changing things for me. I'll be asking for something and he's like, you do it. You know, he's really helping me to understand and realize and walk out the fact that I have kingdom authority, especially over things that have to do immediately with my life. You know, I don't have to put up with just things that are going on or even things that I don't like, you know, because he's given me the authority, you know, through the Bible, through the covenant relationship. The blood covenant relationship gives us the authority to say, no, this is not what's going to happen. Yes, some battles and some issues take a little bit more time, a little bit more you know, work than some other things do, but in the end, we always win. You know, it doesn't have to end up negatively for us. You know, yes, things are going to happen. The enemy's going to get in. They're going to cause problems. I'm going to do something stupid. You know, I plead the blood of Jesus over that. And I'm going to say I do less and less stupid things every single minute of every single day going forward. But things are going to happen and I'm going to have to, you know, come back and fix it. But at the same time, a lot of the stuff I can direct in advance by telling it what it's going to be and what it's going to do and how it's going to happen, when it's going to happen, where it's going to happen, as opposed to just floating through as if I have no control. That's not the type of inheritance I have as a co-heir with Christ. All right. Okay. So that's a portion of a testimony, is just, you know, the Lord is really helping me walk out authority, kingdom authority. You know, and we talk about kingdom authority and all that stuff all the time, but are you actually exercising it? You know, it's one thing to know that you have kingdom authority, but it's another thing to actually, another level to actually be walking out and exercising that authority and that dominion. And let me tell you, it is good. You know, you don't want to get prideful because so many things start working out for you the way you want them to and the way you declare them. But at the same time, you know, that's a benefit that you have as being a kingdom citizen. Speaking of kingdom authority, let's talk about prophetic decrees versus affirmations. I have a lot of believers that are, and somebody that I kind of just started talking with and mentoring a little bit recently, sending me affirmations and stuff for the week. And I've been seeing believers post them on social media and stuff like that. Affirmations are great. They are absolutely great, right? Because you have what you say. The difference between affirmation and a prophetic decree is the prophetic decree is backed up by the word of God, which means that it has Jesus' seal on it, which means it has Holy Spirit resurrection power behind it. And it is being spoken and delivered in faith, which means it's pleasing God. And he's going to unleash every resource, you know, in addition to just, you know, those standard spiritual law resources that come into agreement with the things that you speak. But it's going to release God's resources because it has faith behind it. When you have faith, you're pleasing him. And he's saying, absolutely, yes, I'm getting behind this prophetic decree. I'm getting behind this declaration made in faith. I'm getting behind something that the word of God, you know, says. He's going to make sure that those things come to pass because he's obligated to his word and he upholds all things by the word of his power. So if you didn't get that, let me say it one more time. An affirmation is great. However, it's, you know, really close to positive thinking. When you turn it into a prophetic decree, and no, if you are in marketplace ministry, you do want to have a list of affirmations for people who are not godly. I have that. I have a book that's called I Say So, Speaking My Way to Success. All of those declarations that are in there come right out of the Bible. So they have, you know, Jesus's seal and Holy Spirit resurrection power behind them. They're a blessing to the non-saved world, but they're also being influenced because all of those declarations in there come out of the Bible. They just don't say Jesus said or according to the word or anything like that. So you can have affirmations and things like that, but I'm telling you as a believer, you don't necessarily want to walk around saying, oh, well, I've got these affirmations. What you want to say is, I'm decreeing this, you know, according to the word of God. I'm saying this in faith because you want all of that extra power behind you, backing up things that you can say you can get. Like I said, affirmations are great. They are powerful. But at the same time, as soon as you take out, you know, affirmation or I affirm this and say, I'm declaring this in faith in Jesus Christ, your power goes from here to here. And that's what you want. You want that greater power. That's just my two cents and just from chit-chatting with the Lord and praying in tongues and all this fasting I've been doing the last couple of weeks. I'm in a fast right now. I've already prayed in tongues 3 hours today. Still have one more hour to go. And, you know, one more hour minimum to go, but it's awesome. And that's probably one of the reasons I've been plowing through so much great stuff in this year, because I have stepped up my faith. I've cut out, you know, like 75% of the negativity that was just a normal everyday thing in my life. And yeah, I stopped talking to some people as much as I used to talk to them before. But the thing is that I've got to focus, and I need focus. That's all it is. That's all I'm going to say. I just need focus. I need to go forward and do what me and God are doing together. Okay, so this leads into another thing. So I've been getting all of these things in faith, you know, declaring this is going to happen. This is when it's going to happen. This is how it's going to happen. And it's been working out. It's been manifesting great. But the enemy has been popping up when I was praying for something else and say, oh, well, you can have all those other things, but you're not having this. And so basically I got tired of that and fed up with that. And I'm like, God doesn't withhold anything from me. So you can't withhold anything from me. So I started this recent fast that I'm in, and I wrote my prayer request and asking the Lord to confirm a prophetic word that was spoken to me, because you want to make sure that your prophetic words are confirmed. You want to know that God is behind them, you know, and a lot of times somebody can throw out a prophetic word there and it's kind of obvious or kind of, you know, not that difficult or just a basic thing. Like when people say that you are going to have a healing ministry, okay, well, that's a normal thing. Jesus told you to do that. All of us, you cast out demons, you heal the sick, you raise the dead, all of this stuff. That's everybody. You know, that's everybody. That's just up to you to put your faith in and go out and exercise and demonstrate those things, right? So, but when it comes to specific things, you just want to, you know, go through, make sure that those prophetic words align with your Psalm 139:16 book and all that stuff. So I have this prayer request asking the Lord to confirm in his word that this prophetic word is in my Psalm 139:16 book. And I said, I'll believe I'll have your answer by Thursday, February 21st at 5:59 p.m. And then I wrote down 7 scriptures that confirm my prayer request, right? So these are the 7 scriptures that I wrote down. Anything I ask in prayer, believing I receive, I ask for his confirmation. Okay, I'm believing that I'm going to receive it. That's one of the scriptures that's in Matthew 21:22. Another one, if I ask anything according to God's will, I will know that he's heard me and I'll receive. That's in one of the Johns. A case is confirmed with the testimony of 2 to 3 witnesses. That's in Deuteronomy, and it's also in Peter, I think, maybe Hebrews. Let God's word be true and men be liars. That's in Romans, or either Acts. I'm sorry, I've been reading so much and writing down so many scriptures. I know what the word says. I may not be able to tell you where it's at right now because my mind's so jumbled and everything's moving so quickly. That's another thing. When you start stepping into faith, things speed up at a really, really strange pace. It's so bizarre. I mean, I'm not like tired or exhausted or anything, but everything's moving faster. It's really cool. Okay. If anyone lacks wisdom, this is in James, let him ask of God who gives generously without upbraiding. God doesn't withhold anything from those who walk uprightly. And of course, that's Psalms. And then the one about ask for wisdom, that's in James. So I had 7 scriptures right there that all guarantee God will answer the question that I asked him that will confirm the prophetic word for me. All of those scriptures. And then, of course, there are more, but 7 is a really good number. I love the number 7. Perfect and complete. It has so much meaning, so much great stuff. I have some teachings out there on numbers and things like that that you can look up if you know where to look. And then I was praying something else last night. And again, then I wrote out 7 more scriptures that all guarantee that God will give me the thing that I was asking for. And it was so awesome. And one of the things that, well, let me explain something. The asking part is really quick, because the Bible says that anything you ask in Jesus's name, the Father will give you. Anything you ask in Jesus' name, believing, you'll receive. Anything you ask in Jesus' name, the Father will do. So the Father's glorified in the Son. You have tons of scriptures. I just gave you 3 different scriptures right there that guarantee the things that we ask for, the Lord will give us. But they all hinge on faith. And faith comes by hearing, and hearing by the Word of God. So one of the reasons that I grabbed all those other scriptures for my request is to guarantee, to back up, to remind God of what he said. Because there's another scripture. He said, put me in remembrance of my word, that remind him of why he should give me what it is that I'm asking for. So the asking part is just one time. And then all of the other scriptures are all promises. Yes, I'm giving this to you. 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 Scriptures. So awesome. So there's a little strategy that I use that you can adopt if you want to as well. You know, it's always good to have the Lord's word confirmed in the word. You know why? Because his word doesn't return void. He's not a man who lies. Look at all these scriptures I'm just giving you, telling you why it's going to work for you. You know, He's alert and active, watching over his word to perform, and all that stuff. So just remind him of all those different things when you're asking for stuff. And then you're going to start seeing things come to you, come to you, come to you. Why? Because you're working spiritual laws. You're working biblical principles. You're putting them into action and you're moving forward and trusting God that they're going to come to pass, right? Faith comes by hearing and hearing by the word of God. You ask the Lord for something, you got seven scriptures that back up what you ask for. Bam, you're guaranteed to receive. All right. So those are the different things that I had for you today. Walking in kingdom authority and exercising dominion. Stop listening to negativity when you get flipped onto faith. Showing you that prayer strategy had seven scriptures that backed up and confirmed why the Lord was going to answer me how I want it, when I want it, or, you know, with an answer when I want it by the time, all the stuff, all those scriptures, faith comes by hearing, hearing by the word, all that good stuff. And like I say all the time, you know, I get hyped, so you might need to watch this video more than one time. There's nothing wrong with that, but just get all the good stuff. Oh, and don't forget to listen to those legacy faith teachers. Listen to those legacy faith teachers. If you need your faith increased, if you need to be flipped onto faith so that you are no longer a fearful person, please listen to those legacy faith teachers. They will be a blessing to you. Start with Kenneth Hagin, Oral Roberts, Norvell Hayes, the old heads. They are so good, so powerful. And you just get raring to go, raring to go, raring to go. And I know that when I listen to them over and over again, a lot of their stuff is repeats. You know, they're saying the same things over and over. And then when you listen to Kenneth Hagin's second and third generation, they're saying the same things that Oral Roberts, Kenneth Hagin, Norvell Hayes, and they all say too. But you need that, you know, especially if you're not flipped to faith yet. You need to hear it over and over and over and over again so that your faith can get turned on. I'm telling you, it's such a good life. And you will start to realize how many people around you, they just live in fear. They're afraid of everything. They're afraid of retirement. They're afraid of jobs. They're afraid of missing a day at work because they're not going to have enough money. They're afraid bills won't get paid. They're still crying and whining to the Lord for stuff when he has already done everything. His work is finished. All you have to do is take from spiritual realm and pull into the natural realm. And how do you do that? Faith. Faith, faith, faith is a pipeline through grace. It's available to you because of grace. Faith is a pipeline that turns on the faucet, the spigot, that gets all of that stuff to you. It's so good, so awesome, so amazing. You have no idea. I could just testify and testify and testify and testify constantly, which is awesome because that's the basis of my ministry, is testifying about God's faithfulness. But you should be able to testify too. And speaking of, if you have any testimonies that you would like to share, I would love to hear them. I know God has to be doing something in your life, you know, and you still may be, you know, getting little things, you know, oh, I had this bill due and the Lord helped me get it paid. That's really good, but that's just the beginning. Money is like one of the easiest things to manifest because there's so much of it in the natural. It's, you know, it's like, you know, but I know you may not be where I am with finances. You may be somebody who still needs to pray for provision. I'm not there. All I need to do with provision is I sow seed, I declare it, and it's mine. But I've been doing that financial thing for such a long time because I came out of homelessness, right? You may never have been homeless, so you've always had provision, you know, through jobs or family or whatever. So you may not have to have built up, you know, great faith for finances. But even if you haven't, start dreaming for something bigger so you can start doing amazing things. Like, for instance, I got a testimony at the beginning of the year about somebody who had been saying for a year and a half that they wanted to be a $1,000 seed sower, and they got there. You know, I used to speak that before I sowed $1,000 seeds. Now I speak it. I mean, now I sow them, you know. So you can get to that same place. You absolutely can, but you need to speak that, you know. You need to speak it. Like right now, I'm speaking $10,000 seeds. You know, I didn't even jump to 5,000. I went from 1,000 to 10,000. That's where I'm going for next. All right. I bless you in the name and the authority of the Lord Jesus Christ. I pray that your faith gets turned on. I pray that you start believing God and receiving of your inheritance. You know, you don't want to leave that stuff there because it's not going to do you any good in heaven. You know, like you get there and you'll be like, oh my gosh, I had all of that available to me and I didn't access any of it, or I accessed 1/10 of it. I want all of it. And the great thing, that's what I said about when you get flipped on a faith, is that it's accelerating. It's not taking as long to get things as, you know, it may have done in past days. And I'm fighting battles so much faster, so much quicker, because Satan has already been defeated. All you got to do is hit them with the word of God and it's over. All right. Again, I bless you in Jesus' name. Order some books from the Supernatural You page. All right. Take care.